Srila Prabhupada were very fond of this song and sang it just before Srila Prabhupada's lectures. In Allahabad and in Gorakhpur, Srila Prabhupada fell into a trance after singing the first two lines. And after some time, Srila Prabhupada came back into external consciousness and said, "Now just chant Hare Krishna." Srila Prabhupada said, "This song is a picture of Vrindavan. Everything is there. Srimati Radharani, Govardhan, Mother Yashoda, and all the cowherd boys. Jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Shri Gitavali ki jai. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur ki jai. Shri Vrindavan Dham ki jai. Jayo Radha Madhava. Jayo Kunja Bihari. Jayo Radha Madhava. Radha Madhava. Jaya Kunja Bihari. Jaya Radha Madhava. Jaya Kunja Bihari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha. Jaya Girivara Dhari. Jaya Girivara Dhari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha. Jaya Yashoda Nandana. Jaya Braj Jana Ranjana. Jaya Yashoda Nandana. Jaya Yashoda Nandana. Jaya Braj Jana Ranjana. Jaya Yashoda Nandana. Jaya Braj Jana Ranjana. Jaya Tirvanachari. Jaya Kunja Bihari. Jaya Kunja Bihari. Jaya Jamuna Tirvanachari. Jaya Kunja Bihari. Jaya Jamuna Tirvanachari. Jaya Jamuna Tirvanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava. Jaya Kunja Bihari. गौरचंद्र भगवान की जय। ब्रजभूमि वृंदावन धाम की जय। जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। ऑल गुरु टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज हरे कृष्ण। ऑल गुरु टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज हरे कृष्ण। ऑल गुरु टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज हरे कृष्ण। ऑल गुरु लोटस फीट ऑफ श्री गुरु एंड श्री गौरांग की जय। जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। नमो विष्णु पदाय सर्वसार भूत लक्ष्मी महाविष्णु गोस्वामी नामिनी। नमो विष्णुपति भक्ति वीर स्वामी नामिनी। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाशाचार्य सारिणे। वेरी नाइस। सो वी आर नाउ डिस्कसिंग न्यू चैप्टर। वी आर मिडवे थ्रू स्टार्टिंग पार्ट ऑफ इट। इट्स दक्षा द फादर इन लॉ ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा। ही कर्सेस लॉर्ड शिवा। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग टू वर्सेस टुडे बिकॉज वर्स नंबर 17 डजंट हैव अ परपट। So we'll just read through verse 17 and then we'll meditate upon the verse number 18 which has got the purport. Jai Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Maitreya uvacha. We'll just see the 17 first, yeah? Vinindhyaivam sa girisham apratipam avasthitam दक्षो तथाप उपस्पृश्य क्रुद्धः सप्तुम् प्रचक्रमे। मैत्रेय उवाच विनिन्द्यैवं स गिरीशम्। अप्रतीपम् अवस्थितम् दक्षो अथाप उपस्पृश्य क्रुद्धः शप्तुम् प्रचक्रमे। Let us go to the next verse now. अयम् तु देव यजन इन्द्रोपेन्द्रादिभिः भवः सह भागं न लभतां देवैर् देव गणाधमः। अयं तु देवयजनः। इंद्रोपेन्द्रादिभिर् भवः सह भागं न लभता देवैर्देवगणाधमः अयं तु देव यज्ञ यजन इन्द्रोपेन्द्रादिभिर्भवः सह भागं न लभता देवैर्देव गणाधमः अयं तु देव यजन इन्द्रोपेन्द्रादिभिर्भवः सह भागं न लभता देवैर्देवगणाधमः अयं तु देवयजन इन्द्रोपेन्द्रादिभिर्भवः सह भागं न लभता देवैर्देवगणाधमः अयं तु देवयजन इन्द्रोपेन्द्रादिभिर्भवः सह भागं न लभता देवैर्देवगणाधमः जय वर्ड टू वर्ड सिनोनिम्स ट्रांसलेशंस एंड पर्पस बाय जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय सो वी विल सी द प्रीवियस वर्ड्स फर्स्ट द वर्ड टू वर्ड सिनोनिम्स मैत्रेयः उवाच मैत्रेय सेड विनिंद्य अब्यूजिंग एवं thus saha he that is daksha girisham shiva apratipam without hostility without any hostility avasthitam remaining daksha अथ नाउ अपह वाटर उपस्पृश्य वॉशिंग हैंड्स एंड माउथ क्रुद्धः एंग्री शप्तुम टू कर्स प्रचक्रमे बिगेन टू So Maitreya said, abusing thus, he, that is Daksha, Shiva, without any hostility remaining, Daksha, now water, washing hands and mouth, angry to curse, begin to. Translation, the sage Maitreya continued, thus Daksha, seeing Lord Shiva sitting as if against him, washed his hands and mouth and cursed him in the following words. Now we are, the discussion today is the actual curse of Daksha. Let's see the word-word synonyms and translations. Ayam that
tu
but
deva yajane
in the sacrifice of the demigods
indra upendra
adibhi with
indra
upendra
and others
bhavah
shiva
saha
along with
bhagam
a portion
na
not
labhata
should obtain
devaihi
with the demigods
deva gana
adhamah
the lowest of all the demigods.
It is very painful.
That
but in the sacrifice of the demigods
with Indra,
Upendra
and the others,
Shiva
along with
a portion,
not
should obtain
with the demigods,
the
lowest of the demigods.
So the curse
of Daksha
is,
translation,
the
demigods are
eligible to share
in the oblations of
sacrifice.
But Lord
Shiva,
who is the
lowest of all the
demigods,
should not have
a share.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Purport.
Because of
this curse,
Shiva
was deprived
of his share
in the oblations
of Vedic sacrifices.
It is
due to the curse of
Daksha,
which Sri
Vishwanath Chakravarti
Thakur
comments in this
connection, that
Lord
Shiva
was
saved
from
the calamity
of taking part
with other demigods,
who were all
materialistic.
Lord
Shiva is the
greatest devotee of
the Supreme Personality
of Godhead,
and
it is not fitting
for him to eat
or sit with
materialistic persons
like the demigods.
Thus,
the curse
of Daksha
was indirectly a
blessing.
For
Shiva would
not have
to eat
or sit with other
demigods
who are too
materialistic.
There is
a practical example
set forth
by
Gaur Kishore
Das Babaji
Maharaj,
who used
to sit
on
the side of a latrine,
toilet,
to chant
Hare Krishna.
Many
materialistic persons
used to come
and bother him
and disturb
his daily routine
of chanting.
So,
to avoid
their company,
he used
to sit by the
side of a latrine,
where
materialistic persons
would
not go
because of the
filth
and obnoxious
smell.
However,
Gaur Kishore
Das Babaji Maharaj
was so great
that he
was accepted as a
spiritual master
of
such a great personality
as His
Divine Grace,
Om Vishnupad,
Shri Srimad
Bhakti Siddhanta
Saraswati Goswami
Maharaj, Shri
Prabhupada ki jai.
The
conclusion is
that
Lord Shiva
behaved
in his
own way
to
avoid
materialistic
persons who
might disturb him
in his
prosecution
of
devotional
service.
Srila Prabhupada
ki jai.
Om
Namo Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om
Namo
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om
Namo
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om
Ajnana
Timirandhasya
Jnananjana
Salakaya
Chakshurunmilitam
Yena
Tasmai Shri
Gurave
Namaha.
Shri
Chaitanya Mano
Bhistam
Sthapitam
Yena
Bhutale
Svayam
Rupah
Kadamahiyam
Dadati
Svapadantikam
Vandeham
Shri Guruho श्रीयुतापदकमलम् श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं श्रीकृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितं च हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं दैवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं उदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे जय ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की जय श्रीमद्भगवद्गीता की जय श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत की जय। So here we are discussing about how and why did Mother Sati, that is Mother Parvati, she gave up her body. That is the main question. And this is part of the narration that happens, that takes place. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Kamai stayster hruta gnana prapadyante anya devataha tam tam niyamam asthaya prakritya niyataha svaya. This is 7:20. Those whose intelligence has been stolen by material desires surrender unto demigods and follow the particular rules and regulations of worship according to their own natures. This is a very big instruction for us as devotees and for people at large who worships the demigods. Srila Prabhupada says that
कृष्णस्ते भजेर सेवर चतुर. वन हु वर्शिप्स कृष्णा इज वेरी इंटेलिजेंट. सो इफ यू वर्शिप कृष्णा ऑन वन हैंड एंड वर्शिप डेमिगॉड्स ऑन अदर हैंड, यू आर नॉट गोइंग एनीवेयर. सो एस्पेशली those who are considering themselves intelligent as devotees, we should be very careful in worshipping demigods. We do not disrespect them, but we don't worship them. It will be a kick on Srila Prabhupada's teachings if we as devotees do that. We had an important festival event of Lord Shiva's appearance, Mahashivaratri. It is very apt time to meditate upon the qualities of Lord Shiva. Now, in the future chapters, the background is given, what actually happened for Daksha to curse Lord Shiva. What had happened is that Daksha had 16 daughters. And he gave away in charity daughters to important sages and personalities, including Pitrus also, forefathers, Dharma. And the youngest daughter of Daksha, by the name Sati, goddess Parvati. Always younger children are very close to the parents, you know, especially the father, you know. So, on the request of Daksha's father, Lord Brahma said, now you give Sati in charity to Lord Shiva. And Daksha did not like this. Because Daksha was a monarch, very big emperor. His daughter's wife lived in luxury. And Shiva is a pauper. Doesn't even his bridle hair, you know. He doesn't even comb his hair. Doesn't wear dress. Madman. He calls him madman. So he had to give in charity to him. And that was a thorn in the heart of Daksha. He could not take it. My daughter to be given in marriage to this man. Madman, poor person, ghosts, he stays. So when Daksha was performing a big sacrifice for the welfare of all living beings in the universe, just see the irony. He's performing a sacrifice for all living beings in the universe. He had not invited Lord Shiva. Actually, Lord Shiva was not invited. But Mother Sati, the wife of Lord Shiva, being a lady, she said, well, all of the whole universe are going. Just see the airplanes are filled going to this sacrifice. Everyone is wearing nice dresses and going. All my sisters are going nicely decked up. My father has not called us. We know, but it's okay. My father, he would love me and you to go. Let's go. At the time, Lord Shiva instructs Mother Sati, and that instruction is very vital for all living beings. Lord Shiva says, yes, he's your father, but he has not invited us. For some reason, he doesn't like me. He has created animosity with me. So please don't go where you are not invited. Otherwise, the outcome would be very inauspicious. This was the instruction of Lord Shiva. And this instruction has remained in my heart ever since I studied this. It's really, really helped me. This whole episode is so painful. So still, Mother Sati said, no, I want to go. Anyway, so then here in this case, Daksha comes to the ceremony and it is mentioned how beautifully his body is glowing. Big opulence. There are 49 different kinds, types of fire gods, Agni. All were there present, stood up. Indra stood up. All demigods stood up except two important demigods, Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva. Daksha saw this and he was enraged, very angry. Why he got angry? He was not angry at Lord Brahma, because Lord Brahma then stood up, welcomed him and said, now you must occupy your throne, which he did, and he was his father. Lord Indra was Daksha's father. But Daksha saw Shiva is also sitting. He's not standing up. This is disrespectful to me. Because ultimately he's my son-in-law. And son-in-law has to give respect to the father-in-law. This is true as per social etiquette. This is correct. Son-in-law also bows down to the father-in-law. Father-in-law gives the blessings. That is true. But things are a little different here. The difference is this, that Lord Shiva, Shambhu, is the greatest of the personalities representing Lord Krishna in the material world. As Sadashiv, in his Sadashiv form, he is 84% that of Lord Narayan, Vishnu Tattva. Narayan is 98%, 94%. And Lord Indra, being Jiva Tattva, is 78% like us. We can go to that level. So technically speaking, Daksha is son of Indra, of Lord Brahma, is quite lower than the quality of Lord Shiva. So Lord Shiva was very apt in saying, I'm sitting down. And most of the time he's in trance meditating upon Lord Krishna, Lord Ramachandra, anyways. And Daksha, seeing that, he speak and he spoke very obnoxiously against Lord Shiva. I'm sure all of you have studied these verses before, you know. I'll just repeat those translations just to get the mood here. All sages, brahmanas and fire gods present, please hear me with attention, he said. For I speak about the manners of gentle persons. I do not speak out of ignorance or envy, he said. He doesn't speak out of ignorance or envy. And see what he says. Shiva has spoiled the name and fame of the governors of the universe and has polluted the path of gentle manners because he is shameless and he does not know how to act. Lord Shiva doesn't know how to act. Just see. He has already accepted himself as my subordinate by marrying my daughter in the presence of fire and brahmanas. He has married my daughter, who is equal to Gayatri, and has pretended to be just like an honest person. Just see, he's pretending just like an honest person. Indirectly, he is telling all these things. It goes even worse. He has eyes like monkeys. Lord Shiva, he has eyes like monkeys, yet he has married my daughter whose eyes are just like those of a deer cub. Nevertheless, he did not stand up to receive me. This is the problem. Nor did he think it fit to welcome me with sweet words. This is the problem. So he's seeing at material levels, you know, eyes like monkeys, eyes like deer cub. What is the comparison? I had no desire to give my daughter to this person. See, third person is saying, this person. So if you are in communication, when you want to distance yourself from somebody, and especially when you are angry, and when you are trying to hide something, you speak in third person language. Like, you know, the American president who had sex with Monica Lewinsky, he said, I did not have sex with that woman. Distancing that woman. Same thing here. I had no desire to give my daughter to this person who has broken all rules of civility, he says. Because of not observing the required rules and regulations, he is impure. But I was obliged to hand over my daughter to him, just as one teaches the messages of Vedas to a Shudra. He lives in filthy places, like crematoriums. He's not finished, man, he's going on. And his companions are the ghosts and demons, naked like a madman, sometimes laughing and sometimes crying. He smears crematorium ashes all over his body. He does not bathe regularly, and he ornaments his body with a garland of skulls and bones. Therefore, only in name is he Shiva or auspicious. Actually, he is the most mad and inauspicious creature. Thus, he is very dear to crazy beings in the gross mode of ignorance, and he is their leader. Too much. Srila Prabhupada says, Lord Shiva appeared to be like that, but his name, Shiva, is actually fitting. For he is very kind to persons who are in the darkness of mode of ignorance, such as unclean drunkards who do not regularly bathe. Lord Shiva is so kind that he gives shelter to such creatures and gradually elevates them to spiritual consciousness. Prabhupada says, although it is very difficult to raise such creatures to spiritual understanding, Lord Shiva takes charge of them, and therefore, as stated in the Vedas, Lord Shiva is all auspicious. Thus, by his association, even fallen souls can be elevated. Sometimes it is seen that great personalities meet with fallen souls, not for any personal interest, but for the benefit of those souls. Look at Srila Prabhupada, the same thing. In the creation of the Lord, there are different kinds of living creatures. Some of them are in mode of goodness, some passion, some ignorance. Lord Shiva takes charge of persons who are advanced in Krishna consciousness. Lord Vishnu takes charge. There's the Vaishnavas. Lord Brahma takes charge of persons who are attached to material activities, and Lord Shiva is so kind that he takes charge of persons who are in the gross ignorance and whose behavior is lower than that of animals. Therefore, Lord Shiva is especially called auspicious. And then he even goes against Daksha goes against even Lord Indra. Lord Brahma, his father, says, on the request of Brahma, Lord Brahma, I handed my chaste daughter to him, although he is devoid of all cleanliness in his heart and is filled with nasty things. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, while contemplating Jayato Vishayan Pumshah, Sangas Teshupa Jayate, Sangat Sanjayate Kamaha, Kamat Krodho Vijayate. Our dear Lord says, while contemplating the objects of the senses, a person develops attachment to them, for them. And from such attachment, lust develops, and from lust, anger arises. So attachment starts at the contemplation stage, the subtle stage of thinking. Whether you have seen the thing or not, attachment begins. If you have seen, if you like it, more attachment begins. And then he says, Lord Krishna says, from anger, complete delusion arises. This is the first enemy, first problem. When you're angry, you're deluded. You don't remember, you don't know what you're doing, what you're talking, against whom you're talking. And then from delusion of bewilderment of memory happens. The same person who has helped us, we forget about him. We go away from that personality. We go away from those devotees who have helped us, those living beings. Very offensive. And when memory is bewildered, intelligence is lost. That is the problem. Power of discrimination finishes when memory is lost. And when intelligence is lost, one falls down again into the material pool. This is the point. This is what is Daksha is suffering. He's just seeing on the material level how Lord Shiva is looking like, how he's staying, and what is his beautiful daughter, Mother Sati. Mother Sati is so chaste, she couldn't tolerate this. She gave up her body. It'll come in the next paras, chapter, and next verses. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita further, even Lord Shiva is a demigod. He's a very special devotee of Krishna. In chapter 7, Krishna says, Itar yonini bhutani sarvaniti upadharaya aham krishnasya jagatah prabhavah pralayas tatha. He says, all created beings have their source in these two natures. Of that, of all that is material and all that is spiritual in this world, know for certain that I am both the origin and the dissolution. So Lord Krishna, aham sarvasya prabhavah matah sarvam pravartate, he is the creator of both material and spiritual worlds. Everything emanates from him. The wise who perfectly know this engage in my devotional service and worship me with all their hearts, Krishna says, and he does not tolerate insult to his devotees. Lord Shiva accepts this position on behalf of Lord Krishna. So he's preaching to these living beings who have no other hope. That's why even in our, when we do our offenses against the chanting of the holy names, the first offense is not to be offenseful against those Vaishnavas who are preaching, bringing devotees. Very dangerous. This is the especially importance given by Lord Krishna when he is merciful towards Lord Shiva. Otherwise, who will take care of these ghosts? A ghostly bodied living beings. For unlimited lifetimes, they are suffering in the ghostly body. They cannot come out of that ghostly body. And living beings, as human beings, can also control them, these ghostly bodies, and use them to usher their needs, keep them close to that extent. There are living beings doing like this. Tantrics do like this. Even not only in Vedic Dharma, people follow the Tantras and all. Even in Islam or even in Christianity, this exists. Different grades of ghosts also. Pishachas. So many different levels. Now those people, they have ghostly bodies because they are envious. That's what there is, nothing else. And this envy keeps them trapped in the ghostly body. Now we who do not have ghostly bodies, if we also become envious, what is the difference between us and the ghosts? Same thing really. No difference. And all these things that Daksha was going to speak, Lord Shiva had the foresight and said to Mother Sati, don't go. Nothing good will come out of this. Because don't go where you are not welcomed, my dear chaste wife. Don't go. She went. She lost her life. She couldn't tolerate what's going on. And after that, the whole ceremony was destroyed by Lord Shiva's followers. And that should be. Followers of any great personality should not take offense, should not accept the offense against their guru, against Krishna. Hanuman, Lord Hanuman, burned the whole Lanka for the offense created against Lord Ram. His top servant he is. But Lord Ram did not take the offense. See? Servant took the offense. So Vaishnava doesn't take offense, he forgives. But those who follow should not tolerate. If somebody blesses him, Prabhupada, we should not tolerate. Although Prabhupada may not take the offense. This is how foolishly people think. Oh, Prabhupada has not taken offense, we should not worry about it. This is wrong. This is totally wrong. Prabhupada will not take offense, but we should take offense. Stand up. If not, just walk away. So here, when Daksha is cursed, Lord Shiva, that he will not get the oblations of the sacrifice, Lord Shiva always has a majority portion of any sacrifice. So he has to sit and eat with other demigods or materialistic people. So here, Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur's reference has been given that the curse was actually a blessing for Lord Shiva. And Srila Prabhupada further explains that Shiva wanted it so he doesn't have to sit and eat with these brahmanas, with other demigods who are materialistic people. So what do we learn from this? We learn from this is that do not believe what you see. You must use your intelligence and see what is there, obviously, and what is not there, obviously. Otherwise, people who are not thinking will say, oh, Shiva was cursed by Daksha, so Shiva did not take the oblations and he lost off oblations. Look, why did he pick up a fight with Daksha? He should have stood up, no? What is the problem? That is how majority people think. But introspective sages who study Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita daily, in and out, who try and understand this, that is where Srila Prabhupada is given the reference of Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur to say that it was actually a blessing. So that all these demigods who stood up for their material prosperity against Daksha, Lord Shiva doesn't have to sit and have his oblations with these kind of materialistic people. And further says that this is what Shiva wanted. Srila Prabhupada says this. The conclusion is that Lord Shiva behaved in his own way, to avoid materialistic persons who might disturb him in his prosecution of devotional service. This is the point to be understood. So, my prayers to Srimad Bhagavatam, to Srila Prabhupada, Guru Maharaj and Srila Prabhupada and all the Vaishnavas is that I get the insight to understand what has actually happened rather than seeing what is happening. And this is possible when my heart is pure, when I'm satisfied in my heart, when I'm peaceful, and I can perform my bhajana kriya without disturbance. This is what I understood from this verse, these two verses. All of you are very qualified devotees, and you also have deep knowledge of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam. Would you please like to share your realizations on these verses, please? Please feel free. Okay, any questions anyone has on what we discussed so far? Okay, thank you very much. Jai Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srimad Bhagavad Gita as it is ki jai. Our Savior, Savior of the whole world, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Nitai Gaur Chandra Premanande, Hari Hari Bol. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.